The White House convened more than 80 state legislators from 41 states to discuss access to abortion today. Pennsylvania's first black woman speaker of the Pennsylvania House of Representatives, Joanna McClinton, who led the Pennsylvania delegation to the White House, spoke about how Democrats are defending reproductive rights for Pennsylvania's women. Joanna McClinton joined us on this program after she was sworn in as speaker.
Neighbors do not always know how extreme Republicans behave and how extreme their agenda is. So certainly them moving very quickly on a Friday night in July, our last night of session, to pass a constitutional abortion ban, the first step, it definitely shined a bright light on their agenda. And it exposed what they would try to do if they were to remain in control here in Harrisburg.
Joining us now is House Speaker of the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania, Joanna McClinton. Thank you very much for joining us tonight. Really appreciate it. So at your meeting at the White House with the Vice President, was this informational for the Vice President, meaning you're reporting to her from out there in the field in the states, or was the Vice President also making suggestions about how the administration might be able to help?
So it was definitely a two-way street today at the White House. Vice President Harris was not on the official agenda, so all of us were pleasantly surprised to see her come into our room where we were having the convening and address us, giving us updates on what's happening at the federal level. Certainly, we all know Vice President Harris has been leading in this space, traveling across our nation, meeting with state lawmakers and organizations to make sure that women in this country are not ignored, are not dismissed, and that we have rights in 2023.
And was this as much a campaign discussion as a governing discussion? Obviously there was discussion about what you can do in the legislatures to try to prevent some of these bills from being passed that Republicans are trying to pass. But there's also a campaign issue involved here.
Indefinitely, voters go to the polls every 6 months. Here in Pennsylvania, we're choosing judges on our highest state courts this year, and we know next year we're going to reelect President Biden and Vice President Harris. But we were not there for a campaign event today. We were there on official business, talking about how those of us who are in Democratic majorities are governing and protecting women in our various states.
There have been 563 provisions to restrict access to abortion introduced in state legislatures this year, just in the last year. And some of that is happening in states where Republicans are the majority, but there are Democratic members of those legislatures in minorities that are usually powerless. Was there any strategy developed for them in the minorities that they're in their legislatures to try to work against this?
So, I know all about being a minority. Our caucus was in the minority in Harrisburg for more than a decade. So one of the things that we discussed today was interstate compacts, where states surrounding areas where women do not have access to this critical health care are able to safely go to other states. And we know that the federal government has done a lot for that. But we can look at states like where I live in the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania. We have neighbors from Ohio, from West Virginia, that frequently cross those state lines that come to get this health care to the Pennsylvania to get it. And in addition to that, we have states surrounding us like New York, New Jersey, Maryland, and Delaware that have shield laws that are protecting providers, that have taken a lot of steps not only to protect providers and patients, but to codify this crucial right.
How much can states do to help women with this, what has now become a travel issue? How do they get out of their state where it's illegal to a state where what they need is legal?
Well, there's some interesting legislation pending in New York State that makes sure providers in New York State will not ever be criminally prosecuted by states where otherwise they could not practice. And they're practicing through digital communication. They're having telehealth visits right on a cell phone, prescribing mifepristone and whatever else could possibly be necessary for these women patients who are in states where it's unfortunately no longer available.
Pennsylvania House Speaker Joanna McClinton, thank you very much for joining us tonight, Madam Speaker. We always appreciate it.
Thank you.
Thank you.